Greetings, fellow Wotics. Welcome back to Delta Force. This is definitely, most definitely, the ultimate mission of Indonesia, of the Indonesia campaign. There are two more campaigns remaining, and I'm ever so excited to just finish this entire game today itself. But I shall contain my excitement and spread it out over the next few weeks because I know my limits and I don't want to burn out. Anyway, I digress. I'm talking too much about myself. Today's mission at hand is Ground Zero, wherein we actually acquired the CDC materials from a terrorist base designated Objective Joe. So we got this information after capturing the IMT leader from Operation Lockdown. Now, here's the thing, this entire campaign was never about revenge or retaliation or displaying the strength of the United States, but rather just obtaining materials that were stolen from the United States. Of course, in the process, we did, you know, get to maintain a lot of peace around the globe as well. But apart from that, this mission is primarily about, well, retrieving. This entire campaign was about retrieving the stolen biochemical warfare agents. I wonder why they were creating biochemical warfare agents anyway. I suppose they could be weaponized in that way. Those were for research, I suppose. Anyhow. Whoa, that is a fancy way to the objective. Mission. Retrieve stolen CDC materials from a terrorist base designated Objective Jones. You'll be inserted into position approximately 700 meters north of Objective Jones. Proceed south through your checkpoints, eliminating all perimeter patrols you encounter. Once you have eyes on the objective, neutralize the forces guarding it and then proceed inside and secure the stolen materials. Extreme caution must be used to ensure that the CDC case is not damaged or the entire region could be contaminated. If the case is damaged, the mission will be a failure. Your success depends on finding the CDC briefcase and reaching your extraction point. Something tells me I cannot use grenades to clear out rooms in this mission, which makes it just all the more difficult. Expected enemy forces, a special reconnaissance team has mapped out the area of the objective and the strength of the force stationed there. They report a force between 2 and 3 platoons strong dug into positions defending the shallow valley where the objective is located. While they reported several vehicles at the objective, no air support was sighted. Well, the air support wasn't really of help last time either. Allied support. Alpha team will be inserted into position 960 meters northeast, right here. Comparatively close to me. I like it. They will support your left flank as you move into the objective and will hold position in the perimeter to suppress enemy fire during your ingress and egress. So they'll only, you know, take me into the actual place. Charlie team will be inserted 575 meters south of the objective. They will secure the southern perimeter and then move into the objective to support your assault and search for the CDC briefcase. Okay, so the Charlie team is actually helping me, which means that they'll be the first to die. Got it. Situation. After extensive questioning by both J2 and Indonesian army officers, the IMT leader has revealed the location of the stolen CDC materials. I like how to say questioning and not interrogation, let alone enhanced interrogation techniques. Anyway, the bio agents are reportedly still within their original case at an IMT base on New Guinea. Isn't New Guinea supposed to be somewhere in Africa? I thought this was the Indonesia campaign. I'll have to confirm that. Maybe I was wrong. Anyway, I'll probably leave a comment in the, you know, when I'm editing, if I'm wrong. The bioagents are considered level 4 biohazards, so their safe recovery is of paramount importance. Extreme care must be taken during this mission. I cannot speak. During this mission, to not release the bioagents. So basically, no grenades. M4 and plus M203, even though grenade launcher is sort of a moot point. Double load ammo, and I would like Spec Ops 45. Thank you. So, yeah, let's go ahead and start this mission then. Let's see what this is all about. Attempt number 7. Second attempt with the sniper rifle because, well, somebody got a lucky shot on me. And we just gotta outlock them, that's all. This mission has been getting a little frustrating, so I decided to take it a little slow.
Bravo, we're moving parallel to your approach.
Roger Alpha, awaiting your approach. Now, I hope I do not miss the shots like I did last time.
Charlie is at the perimeter.
Oh, you did not. How did that miss? You can like waste an entire magazine full of ammo on these people who are running. And there comes the lag to throw off my timing. Or rather, there came the lag. It's no longer there. It just came and it went as if it owned the place. Now, there should be a few people here. Yeah, there they are. Come on, don't be shy. The trick to sniping, I do believe, is patience and calculating your shots instead of just going full auto like you would with an assault rifle. So, with that being said, that's one guy down. That's another guy down. Another guy down. There is that person over there.
Charlie 2 is down!
No, Charlie 2. It should have been me, not him.
Check east! Shooters east!
You're the only people east, Alpha. But yeah, what about this guy? Can I get him from here, I wonder? I think the shot went over his head. Yes, I can, and I did. Oh, there you are.
Bravo, we see two patrols in the valley.
Roger, Alpha. Finally, of all the shots that I had to waste on that guy. Alpha 1, who killed Alpha 1? Okay, let's go get those buggers. Whoever killed Alpha 1 is going to pay. And I'm going to meet them. Now, one of the things that I dislike about this is, even though it has like a nice large scope on it, it does not have a grenade launcher option, which is instrumental in clearing out a lot of the bunkers. So it's sort of like a trade-off using one gun for another in this mission. I mean, I suppose all guns are trade-off, but I would appreciate if they gave us more grenades as well with the double load ammo perk. Okay, you got shot. Oh no, you did not. How do these people always know when I'm about to shoot and do that? There you are. That's you gone. And what about you guys? That's one little piggy. Two little piggy. Come here, little piggy. Time for you to die. These little piggies are gone already? No, this one is still very much alive. Too high. Just perfect. Cool. Who else? Who else is there? I think there are a few people down there, but of course, they will not be visible to all of us. And I think we are clear to proceed. So yeah, I mean, for this mission, I'm just going to take it slow and methodical. Just sweep the entire area, kill everybody on scene before I move on to the next sector. This mission is difficult. It is quite the difficult mission. No joke about that. Definitely one of the more difficult missions out there. As far as this game is concerned, I mean. Alpha already seems to be at the outer perimeter. I don't know how he managed that, but he did. Good on him, I suppose. I'm going to be climbing this mountain right now. This hill, not mountain. It is not a mountain, but a hill. I can hear some people firing shots at me, but that's just a tree, not a person. I wonder where the shots are coming from.
Charlie 1 is down!
How is Charlie 1 down? Who killed Charlie 1? These are the questions that my heart wishes to know. And who's shooting at me, I wonder, right now? Probably these people down here. There are two of them. Yep. Right there. Thank God for... giving us extra ammunition. That one extra round of ammunition. For when you're reloading that you already have in the chamber and can utilize. I suppose that is also specific to the Delta Force, is it? That style of loading, so to speak. Reloading, rather. That they just reload whenever they run out of ammunition. Instead of... like when the magazine gets empty, they reload instead of waiting for their guns to run dry. So they already always have one bullet in the chamber. Down the barrel. So about the zoom in this game, one of the things that I noticed was how you notice how you can see the rest of the map and the zoom only covers like a part of the screen on just the right hand side. And I was thinking about that and I realized that a lot of special operations they prefer to keep both eyes open when they look peer down a scope. So it could totally be that, you know, both of them, the operative keeping both of his eyes open. Because as far as I remember, if I remember correctly at all, Delta Force is Spec Ops. And I mean, they're supposed to be Green Berets. So I think logic follows that they like to keep their... keep one eye open when they operate the sniper, or pretty much look down any scope for that matter, so that they can see what's going on around them. I can hear some bullets ricocheting here and there, but I'm not sure whether that is relevant to me or not. You sure are, sir. You sure were relevant to me. And what about the people over there? Are there... yes, there is one person that I would love to shoot. Pretty sure there were more people up there that were going to be a problem later on. Thus far, I can only see two more people. Probably someone down here.
Bravo has eyes on target. No evidence of contamination.
Copy Alpha. Proceed with mission.
No, I suppose not. There is nobody here, I suppose. Everybody seems dead, I mean. Except for this guy. Don't know what he's doing. But he's up to no good is what I can tell. Now, we just need to search this area and hopefully we don't get shot and die. Now, this being one of the reasons why I wanted to take out as many folks as I could from the map before entering. Is that they can shoot you. They can pretty much shoot you dead if you're not careful. So, especially the people in these barracks, they can shoot you dead. That guy said. And what about anybody here? I don't see anybody there. What about people over here? Well, I am getting shot from somewhere, I just can't figure out where it is. I see somebody there, so I'm gonna take a shot. But I suppose it's from over there. And I can't tell who's shooting at me and where from. but I can just tell that I am getting shot, so I'm just gonna go for it. Get in. Nobody there. This is, I suppose, a pretty safe spot for me, unless the game decides to reboot. Oh, sorry, crash. And not let me search anymore, so to speak. There seem to be some people in there. Not in here, no. There's nobody in here, but I do believe there are some people over there. And I do not believe that is the bomb. But I need to be a little careful in my approach here. I could easily risk death. Ah, that is the suitcase that I was looking for. Come on. Come on.
Package is secure. Proceeding to extraction point.
Now I need to exfiltrate from this area without dying, hopefully. I will just
Black Widow is approaching the LZ. Bravo. We've got your escape.
Roger, Black Widow. Now, I'm trying to find out who's shooting at me. Because the shots seem to be coming from somewhere up there in the sky. So I can't really tell who's shooting at me. I can just hope that they don't shoot me in the back while I'm running away. You're dead. Did he just say my balls in Indonesian? Because I did. I do think I shot him the balls, so. There should be a person up, inside of this bunker who I do want to take care of. So, let's just go up this bunker for a short little detour and let's pull out our grenades. Because, this is gonna be fun. I don't exactly want to give this guy the opportunity to shoot me in the back. Yeah, that's it. That's all I wanted. Okay, let's go. Are there any hostiles on the way to the extraction point? None that I can see. Let's go then. I hope I do not fall and die. This mission has been pretty difficult and I would hate to lose it at the very end like this. I cannot see any hostiles. On the path to success, I hope that the game does not bug out. It should not, because there aren't any really structures around for it to bug out, but you never know. You never know how these things are gonna go. Also, I think using DGVoodoo is giving me some rendering issues, or it might be just a native part of the game. Who knows, but yeah, apparently when this game came out, it had like quite a few bugs which had been taken care of through a patch which you can no longer download because, well, the website you had to log into to download the patch no longer works. I mean, it does work, but they send you an email confirmation and the mailing servers are down, so they never send you an email confirmation anymore. L16. Cool. And I suppose, yeah, Alpha or Charlie, I forgot which one it is, either of them, is right there. So let's read the mission statistics then. Finally managed to finish that mission. 49 kills, probably around 55 to 60 people on the map there. Bravo team has recovered the stolen CDC bioagents. The safe return of those bioagents to the CDC marks the defeat of the IMT. Congratulations, Bravo team. Bravo, bravo. And with that, we have successfully completed the Indonesia campaign, and boy, was it a difficult mission at last, at the end there. If that is the standard of missions from now onwards, then boy, am I in for a ride. But anyhow, the next time we come back, we will be tackling either Operation Raven or Operation Manticore in Uzbekistan. Start kicking off a new campaign, essentially. Until then, thanks for tuning in today. And we finished the Indonesian campaign. That's a big achievement for me, personally. For us. For all of us. We're all doing this together, aren't we? We're in this together, this journey. Anyway, thanks for watching. farewell and take care, fellow Earthlings.